Peace be unto you. Today's lesson will be the mark of the beast. Today I'm going to reveal to you what is the mark of the beast, what the mark of the beast really is. Alright? So, let's go into the scriptures. Alright? Let's go to Revelation chapter 13. Okay. So we're going to bust certain myths out there. Yes. Yes, going to bust certain myths out there. Alright. So let's see what the mark of the beast really is. Let's see. Alright. Revelation chapter 13, verse 16. And he caused it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand. So he caused it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. This all doesn't mean everyone on earth, okay? It means all of those that worship the beast, okay? All of those that worship the angel of the bottomless pit, they will receive this mark. So this is not speaking to every individual on the earth, alright? Let's go on, it says, yeah, so they receive it in their right hand or in their foreheads, see? In their foreheads are in their right hand, okay? So notice it says in their forehead and in their right hand. I know that the hidden wisdom to the right hand is that Christ is the right hand of God. So right hand, it represents a person. So this mark is in you. See, the mark of the beast is something that's in you. I'm going to reveal it to you. Alright? So let's go on. It says, verse 17, that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Okay, no man cannot buy or sell, save he that had the mark. Meaning you cannot be in the congregation and the companion of certain people if you don't have this mark in you, because buying and selling is basically believing and teaching, right? Sharing wisdom, right? Selling is sharing wisdom, okay? And buying is believing. That's hidden wisdom to it, but the carnal mind would not see this, all right? But I won't get deep into that, but that's what it is saying. All right, so let's go on. It says, and that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark are the name of the beast or the number of his name. Verse 18, here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. Stop right there. It is the number of a man. Okay, so this beast is a man, and his number is 666. Okay, and this image and this name is of this man. Alright, so we're gonna find out who this man is. Alright, so it says, and his number is 666. Alright, that's his number. So the Bible refers to this man as a beast. Alright. So where did we read about the beast in the past? Alright, in Genesis chapter 3, verse 1. Alright, let's go there. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1. Alright. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field, right? So the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field, meaning that he was more clever, he was more ingenious than any other beast of the field. And this beast is a man, okay? So he's more ingenious than any other man in this world, because Christ said that the field is the world, right? See, the field is the world. Go to Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter 13, verse 38. The field is the world. See? So the field is the world. So it says when he was more subtle than any beast of the field, meaning that he was more subtle than any other man of the world. See? That's what I said, is not all will receive this mark. Only the world will receive it. Those that worship the angel of the bottomless pit. Right? They will receive this mark. Right? Let's go on. It says, the field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. See, that the good seed are the children of the kingdom. I know that the seed is the word of God. Alright, and it says, But the tares are the children of the wicked one. See, that tares are the children of the wicked one. Those that worship the mark of the beast. Right? And remember, the seed is the word of God, you know. So you have the seed of Satan as well, which is the word of the devil. And the word of the devil is in them. See, so that's the mark of the beast. It's a spirit. Alright, the mark of the beast is a spirit. Let's go on some more. Let's go on some more. Alright. Let's go to Habakkuk chapter 1. Verse 4. No, let's go to Revelation 9. Revelation chapter 9. Revelation chapter 9 verse 11. And they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit. Right, so they have the king over them, those that worship the beast. The angel of the bottomless pit is their king. Alright, and this is who they worship, the angel of the bottomless pit. Let's go and says, whose name in the Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue hath his name Apollyon. Right, so in the Greek his name is Apollyon, in the Hebrew his name is Abaddon. Alright, and this is the king of the king of the swarm, which comes up out of the bottomless pit. Alright, so now let's go on. Now let's go to Revelation 13 verse 8. And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him. See that? All that dwell upon the earth shall worship him. All those are in the world, those which are in the field shall worship him. Right, so the sons of God will not worship him, only those which are wandering after the beast. Okay, so it says, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written. See that? See, so it's not everybody will receive the mark of the beast. So it says all. You see, it says, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb. See that? Only those which names is not written in the Lamb book of, in the book of life of the Lamb. All right, so let's go to Exodus chapter 32 verse 32 and 33. It says, yet know if thou wilt forgive their sin, and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book which thou hast written. Right, so so Moses is asking the Lord, if he'll forgive their sin, then blot his name out of the book. Right, And he was praying, God, he said, I pray thee, right? Block my name out of the book which thou hast written. And the book which he had written is the Lamb's book of life. That's what we had read in Revelation. Right? So it's, verse 33 says, and the Lord said unto Moses, whosoever hath sinned against me, him will I blot out of my book. So it's whosoever sinned against him by worshipping the angel at the bottomless pit, he will blot out of this book. So if you worship the angel at the bottomless pit, your name is not written in this book. See it? Your name is not written in the book. Right? Mean your name is not written in heaven. Alright? Let's go on. Let's go back. It says, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb. See? Those which whose name is not written in the book of the Lamb. Right, they shall worship the beast. Alright, so it says, Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. Right? The Lamb which was slain from the foundation of the world. Okay, so now, yeah, he was slain from the beginning, because Abel represented Christ, you know. Abel, and he was killed by his brother, which was a foreshadow of what would happen to Christ. See, which is he being killed by the Jews, which was his people. See, so that's what I mean by Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. See, Abel represented Christ. See, so Let's go to Ezekiel. No, let's go to Revelation chapter 13 verse 1. And I stood upon the sand of the sea. Right, so John said, so John is saying that he's standing upon the sand of the sea. Right, he stood upon the sand of the sea. Okay, what's the sand of the sea? Let's find out what's the sand of the sea. Okay. Go to Genesis chapter 32 verse 12. Right. Genesis chapter 32 verse 12. And thou saidst, I will surely do thee good and make thy seed as the sand of the sea. Alright? So he was saying that he would make Jacob's seed as the sand of the sea. I will see that John saying, I stood upon the sand of the sea. Alright? Alright, so let's go to Psalm 29:10. Psalm 29:10. No, let's go to Psalm 29:3 first. Psalm 29:3. Alright. Psalm 29:3. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. See? That's why I say I stood upon the son of the sea. I know that waters are people, multitude, nations, and tongues. Right? So he says, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. And the voice of the Lord is John. You see, the voice of the Lord is Saint John the Divine. Alright, so watching it says, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters, the glory of the God of glory thundereth. The Lord is upon many waters. Yes, man, even as the thundercats, the Lord thundereth. You see, watching out here, verse 10. The Lord sitteth upon the flood. See, so the Lord sits upon the flood. The Lord sits upon multitudes of people. If so, he sits upon I, you see? He's sitting upon me. Alright, so it says, the voice of the Lord. No, the Lord sitteth upon the flood. Yea, the Lord sitteth king forever. See that the Lord sitteth king forever. He's sitting in the throne in my mind, right? He's king forever. He's the idol of my heart. Right? Let's watch it now. Let's go to Isaiah 10:22. Isaiah 10:22. For though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, see that? Though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, and John said, I stood upon the sand of the sea. Alright? Says, yet a remnant of them shall return, the consumption decreed shall overflow with righteousness. Right? So now we'll read Revelation 13:1. Go back again. Yeah, Revelation 13:1. Let's go back. And I stood upon the son of the sea. So John is now standing upon the children of Israel. See, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters, which is his people. Alright, so John said, I stood upon the son of the sea. See that? Alright. So it says, and I saw a beast rise up out of the sea. So when he was upon the sea, which was upon Israel, he saw a beast rise up in Israel. Alright, so now this is a rebellious folk rising up now in Israel. A rebellious people rising up. So let's see what's this rebellious people that is rising up now. Alright. Let's go to Acts 20:28. Alright. Acts 20:28. Take heed therefore unto yourselves and to all the flock over the which Holy Ghost hath made you overseer. Alright? So I should take heed therefore unto myself and unto the flock. Right? I says, over the which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseer. See, so the Lord has made me an overseer over the flock. Alright? And he says, I should take heed unto myself and to the flock. So take heed unto yourself and to the doctrine. See that? That's what he says. Holy Ghost hath made you overseer to feed the church of God. See, he had made me overseer to feed the church of God. And he says, which he had purchased with his own blood. See that? He had purchased me with his own blood. Even the church. So I'm here to strengthen the church. Right, so it says, verse 29, for I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves. See that? So you know after his death, you know that grievous wolves would enter in among you. See that grievous wolves would come in the flock. That's why in Revelation 13:1, John saw a beast rising up out of the sea. See, it's a rebellious people rising up in the midst of Israel. Right? In the midst of his people, in the midst of his congregation, is a rebellious people rising up. Right? So he says, let's go on. He says, for I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. See that? So wolves have crept in and brought in heresies and false doctrines, right, amongst our people, and is spreading it. Alright? Let's go on. It says, also of your own selves shall men arise. See that? Also of your own selves shall men arise amongst the body. See? That's what I'm saying. Saw a beast rising up out of the sea. Right? As he stood upon the son of the sea. Because the son of the sea is the children of Israel. Alright? So watch it. It says, also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. Therefore, watch and remember that by the space of 3 years I cease not to warn everyone night and day with tears. Yes, I'm in the mountains crying night and day, cutting myself with stones. You understand? So let's go to 1 John 2. 1 John chapter 2. So this beast is the serpent. Right, a rebellious people rising up amongst the children of Israel. For the darkness and the light are both alike. You understand? 1 John chapter 2. Sure, 1 John. Alright. 1 John chapter 2 verse 18 and 19. Little children, it is the last time. See that? It is now. The end is come. This is the last days. The end is now come. Right? It says, they went out from us. No, little children, it is the last time. And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come. See that? Wolves coming in, not sparing the flock. See that? Antichrist coming in amongst the children of Israel. So it says, heard that Antichrist shall come. Even now are there many Antichrists. See that? Even now. That's what I tell you. Say the end is now. So he said, even now there are many Antichrists. See that? Even now. So it says, even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time. See, and that's how we know that we are in the last days, because we are seeing these things. We have seen men and in videos spreading lies, you know, lying against the Lord and speaking things that they ought not to speak. You understand? So it says, verse 19, they went out from us. See that? They went out from us, meaning they went out from the word of God. They went out from the ground of truth, the pillar of truth. Watch it. It says, thus went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out, that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us. See that? They went out and made manifest. That's why he said that he saw a beast rising up. See, made manifest that they were not of us. See, rising us. Iniquity was found in their hearts. Go to Ezekiel. Ezekiel. Book of Ezekiel. Book of Ezekiel chapter 28 verse 14 to 6 verse 14 to 17. Thou art the anointed cherub that covereth. Yes. So these people were the anointed cherub that covereth. See? They were this, you know. He says, and I have set thee so. So God had set them so. Thou was upon the holy mountain of God. See that? They were upon the holy mountain of God. Thou hast walked up and down in the midst of the stones of fire. See, they were in the midst of the stones of fire. Even as I am cutting myself with stones and crying night and day. Right? So it says, thou was perfect in thy ways from the day that thou was created. See, they were perfect. Till iniquity was found in thee. See that? Till hatred was found in thee. Till perverse things was found in thee. Till bad mind was found in thee. You see? Till envyings was found in thee. Till murders was found in thee. Right? Till fornication was found in thee. Alright? So watch it, it says. But the multitude of thy merchandise, they have filled. But by the multitude of thy merchandise, they have filled the midst of thee with violence. See? By the multitude of thy merchandise. See that? Which is your riches of darkness, treasures of wickedness. See? Treasures of wickedness, which is in them heart. Evil plots, see it, against the people of God. But it says, by the multitude of thy merchandise, they have filled the midst of thee with violence. See that? See that? They are filled with violence according to the multitude of their riches. See, because lies. So it says, that's why Christ said that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence up until this day. See, suffered violence from the beast, right? So it says, and thou hast sinned. See, he has sinned. Therefore, I will cast thee as a profane out of the mountain of God. See, that's how he was cast out. Right? Because iniquity was found in him. And he's now rising up among the children of Israel because iniquity is found in him. So I'm cast out, so I'm rising up as a beast, you see? So, you know, it says, I will cast thee to the ground, I will lay thee before the kings that they may behold thee. Right? So the Lord is going to bring them down. Right? Because he's able to graft them in back again, you know, if they're willing to come back. He's able to graft them in again. Right? He's able to graft them in again. Right? So it says, thine heart was lifted up because of thy beauty. Right? Same merchandise. Same treasures of wickedness. Beauty. See? Gems, precious things, pretty things. Beauty. which represent the spirit. See that? So it says, thou hast corrupted thy wisdom by reason of thy brightness. See that? By reason of their dark wisdom. So it says, I will cast thee to the ground, I will lay thee before kings that they may behold thee. Right? So that we may see them when they are fallen, right, and perish. Right, so watch it now. Let's go to Psalm 73 verse 22. Let's go to Psalm 73 verse 22. For he said he saw a beast rise up out of the sea. I'm going to show you what's the mark of the beast. Because we said his mark is what? 600, 3 and 6, which is 666. And the people receive it in their right hand or in their forehead. See? Or in their forehead. I'll show you something quickly. Revelation 14 verse 1. Revelation 14 verse 1. And I looked and lo, a lamb stood on the Mount Zion, and with him 144,000. Having his father's name written in their foreheads. See that? So the 144,000 have the father's name written in their forehead, which is in their mind. So that means the mark of the beast must be in your mind. Right? Because you receive it in your forehead or in your right hand. Alright. Psalm 73 verse 22. So foolish was I. See that? So foolish was I. Because I was a Gentile led unto these dumb idols. Right? So it says, so foolish was I. Yeah, I was foolish. He says, so foolish was I and ignorant. I was as a beast before thee. See, I was as a beast. See that? Foolishness, ignorance. That's the mark of the beast. Not knowing the Lord, being alienated from the life of God. See that? Not being baptized. Not be believing and being baptized. Right? So watch it now. Let's go on to himself. Daniel. Let's go to Daniel 5. Daniel chapter 5. Look up Daniel. Alright. The book of Daniel chapter 5, verse 21. I start from verse 20. It says, but when his heart was lifted up, which is Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, right? He says, when his heart was lifted up, his heart was lifted up, meaning he became proud and haughty and had forgotten the Lord, the Holy One of Israel, right? So it says, but his heart was lifted up and his mind hardened in pride, even as Pharaoh's heart was hardened, right? And refused to let the children of Israel go. See? Same way Pharaoh's heart was hardened. So, watch it, it says, and he was driven from the sons of men, and his heart was, but when his heart was lifted up and his mind hardened in pride, he was disposed from his kingly throne. So he was disposed. Even as though they were cast out. Why? Because iniquity was found in them. See, they were cast out by their own wickedness. See, and now they're rising up as a beast. See that? They're rising up as a beast out of the sea. See, that's what it does. Go on, let's say. Let's go on. It says, but when his heart was lifted up and his mind hardened in his pride, he was disposed from his kingly throne, and they took his glory from him. See that? Yes. So when you have the mark of the beast, the glory of God is taken from you. See, you don't have the light of God anymore when you have the mark of the beast. So that's what you know. It says, verse 21. And he was driven from the sons of men, and his heart was made like the beast. See that? His heart was made like the beast, which is his mind. See, his forehead was made like the beast. Watch you know. It says, meaning he was made in ignorance and foolishness. See? See, lacking the knowledge of God, you see? Watch it, and it says, and he was driven from the sons of men, and his heart was made like beasts, and his dwelling was with the wild asses. His dwelling was with the wild asses. See that? The wild asses. See that? Those that are free from righteousness. See, the wild asses, free from righteousness, man. Watch it, and it says, they fed him with grass like oxen. See that? Fed him with grass like oxen. And his body was wet with the dew of heaven. See that? So I'm receiving a different knowledge now. Right? I'm receiving a different knowledge. Not the knowledge of God. But the lie of Babylon. The lies of Babylon. Are the wine of her fornication. That's what I'm receiving now. You see? That's what I'm teaching now. You see? So it says, grass like oxen. And his body was wet with the dew of heaven. Till he knew that the Most High God ruled in the kingdom of men. You see, because through judgment you know the Lord, you know. Right? So this dew of heaven is also the righteous words. The words of the righteous. See? So when him now become a wild ass and hear the word of God, it is able to convert him. You see that? It says that till he knew that the Most High God ruled in the kingdom of men. So right, so this is what I'm doing. I'm preaching unto you that you may know that the kingdom of that the Lord rules in the kingdom of men. You see it? See it? I'm watering you with the dew of heaven. See it? I'm feeding you with grass like oxen. Right? Because flesh is grass. Right? And Christ said, eat my flesh, and my flesh is meat indeed. See, that's what it says. Men and that he appointed over it whomsoever he will. And though. So the mark of the beast is a spirit. See that? It's a spirit. Mark of the beast is a spirit. Let's go to 1 Kings 12. 1 Kings chapter 12. So when worship, so the mark of the beast now is where is the spirit of worshiping idols. See? Spirit of worshiping the angel of the bottomless pit, worshiping what gods of wood and stone, gods that cannot profit. Right? 1 Kings chapter 12, verse 26. And Jeroboam said in his heart, see that he said it in his heart, see that the mark of the beast. Can I hear him saying in his heart now to show you that's about the mark of the beast? Watch it now. And Jeroboam said in his heart, now shall the kingdom return to the house of David if this. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And Jeroboam said in his heart, now shall the kingdom return to the house of David. So you see? So he was contemplating in his mind that all the people is now going to serve David. Now all the people are going to be friends with David again. Right? And he's going to lose that. See? So he had envy in his heart. He coveted David. He coveted the house of Judah in a negative way. See? Because he never committed righteousness to be like David. You know? He wanted basically the praise of men basically. He wants the whole number of flesh to be in his presence. That's what he wanted, you see. And Jeroboam said in his heart, now shall the kingdom return unto the house of David. See, the kingdom, so he never wanted the kingdom return. Meaning, because the kingdom of heaven is within you, you know. So he didn't want the people's hearts to draw to David back again. See, he didn't want the people's to be interested in David anymore. That's what he wanted, this is what he says. And Jeroboam said in his heart, now shall the kingdom return to the house of David. If these people go up to do sacrifice in the house of the Lord at Jerusalem. See, so I'm saying that if they go up to do sacrifice, David will take their hearts back again. Right? And he didn't want that. He wanted subjects still. So he says, and if these people go up to do sacrifice in the house of the Lord at Jerusalem, then shall the heart of these people turn again to their Lord, even unto Rehoboam. See, their heart will turn to the Lord, even unto Rehoboam. See that? Rehoboam, king of Judah. So he was against the Lord in plotting these things and contemplating these ideas. And so he says, and they shall kill me and go again to Rehoboam, king of Judah. See that? And they shall go up, they shall go again to Rehoboam, king of Judah. In verse 28 now. Whereupon the king took counsel. See, he took advice and made two calves of gold and said unto them, it is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. So now he came up with a plan to keep them from going up to Jerusalem to do sacrifice. See, came up with a plan. He kept them back with what? A lie, with a fraud, which is what? He says, if these people go up to do sacrifice in the house of the Lord. Sorry. Whereupon the king took counsel and made two calves of gold and said unto them, it is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. See what I'm telling him? He said, it is too much for them to go up there. So he made it seem hard for them to reach. Even as though you have men nowadays making it hard to reach perfection. You see? I'm trying very hard. See, so they make the way of the Lord seem hard and not easy. And Christ said, my burden is light. Right? So let's go on. It says, and said unto them, it is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. Behold thy gods, O Israel, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And he set the one in Bethel and the other he put in Dan. So these were false images. These were dead. These are inanimate objects. Inanimate objects, right? Set up as gods. Right? So, he said no. Verse 30. And this thing became a sin. See that? This thing became a sin. So, the mark of the beast is basically sin. See? when you're not believing on Christ. You say not believing on him. Saint John, sure. Saint John. Saint John chapter 16, verse 9. Saint John chapter 16, verse 9. Of sin because they believe not on me. See that? Of sin because they believe not on me. Right? And Jesus said, when the Spirit of truth is come, he shall reprove the world of sin. Of sin because they believe not on me. So those that don't believe on him and they worship the beast, right? Their name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And they are sinners. These are sinners. Those that don't believe in Christ and worship the beast, these are sinners. Right? Let's watch it now. Let's go on. It says, yeah, let's go to 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 12. Second Peter chapter 2, verse 12. But these as natural brute beasts, see that? But these as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed. All right, let's see what they were doing. Verse 11. Verse 10, it says, but chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanness and despise government. See that? Them hate the men that the Lord set over them. See that? The men that the Lord set over them in truth. You know, so it's not every man that that is set up over you is of the Lord. Those that have set over you in truth. Right, so I'm saying, presumptuous are they, self-willed, they are not afraid to speak evil of dignities, right? They speak evil of the way of truth. They speak evil of Christ, they blaspheme him, his name and his tabernacle. Right, so it says, whereas angels which are greater in power and might bring not a railing accusation against them before the Lord. See, so these are accusers of the brethren. Those that have the mark of the beast, they accuse you of sin. See, they accuse you without any evidence. But these as natural brute beasts made to be taken and destroyed speak evil of the things they understand not. See, so these, they speak evil of the things they understand not. This is the beast that is rising up out of the sea. They speak evil of the things which they understand not. See, meaning they speak evil against the house of God. Things which they understand not. Right? That's what it says. And shall utterly perish in their own corruption. Yes, they shall utterly perish in their own corruption. Yes, that's what will happen. You see, and they shall receive the reward of unrighteousness as they that count it pleasure to riot in the day in the daytime. See, in the daytime when you have light, them keeping the light from you. See, them holding the light, them hiding it. And they're in the daytime, see, so they know it enough, but they're not showing it to you. You see that? Spots they are and blemishes, sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with you. Yeah, spots and blemishes. You know, preventing the edification of the brethren with lies. You know, stopping revelations. Alright, so Joshua chapter 7 now. Let's go to Joshua. Joshua chapter 7, verse 15. And it shall be that he that is taken with the accursed thing shall be burnt with fire. See, that he that is taken with the accursed thing shall be burnt with fire. Right, so those that worship the beast and his image and his name shall be burnt with fire. Right? Let's go to Revelation. Revelation chapter 14, verse. Okay, Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God. See that? The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God. So if you worship the angel of the bottomless pit, he shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is what? Fire. Right? He shall be burned with fire. Okay, so it says, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. See that? Which is poured out into his cup. And what is his cup? What is his cup? The cup is he that he has said. You see? So watch it now. The cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels, in the presence of the Lamb. Yeah. He shall be tormented with fire in the presence of the holy, in the presence of the holy angels and the Lamb. See there, Revelation 11. Verse 10. And they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry, and shall send gifts one to another, because these two prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. See that these two prophets, which are two witnesses, the two olive trees, they tormented them that dwell on the earth. Why? Because they have received the mark of the beast. See, so they are tormented with fire. You see, because they have received the mark of the beast. They are unbelieving. They are in their unbelief. Alright? So those that possess the accursed thing, which is the mark of the beast, shall burn with fire, which is they have been tormented by the word. See that? Let's go to Joshua 7. Joshua 7 verse 18 to 21. It says, and he brought his household a man. Yeah. And he brought his household man by man. And Achan the son of Carmi, the son of Zabdi, the son of Zerah, the tribe of Judah, was taken. And Joshua said unto Achan, my son, give, I pray thee, glory to the God of Israel, and make confession unto him. Right? So Joshua said unto Achan, make confession, right? Make a confession. Confess what you have done. And tell me now what thou hast done. Hide it not from me. See that? So he was told not to hide what he had done. And he says, and Achan answered Joshua and said, indeed I have sinned against the Lord God of Israel, and thus have I done. See, not as Jeroboam. See, because Jeroboam didn't repent. But he repented, see? He confessed. He didn't say repent, but he confessed, right? And Jeroboam didn't confess that he sinned in what he had done, see? Against the Lord God of Israel, and thus have I done. When I saw among the spoils a goodly Babylonian garment, see? The wine of Babylon. A Babylonish garment. Is it? Because the garment is spiritual, you know. It's a spiritual garment. It says, when I saw among the spoils a goodly Babylonian garment, and 200 shekels of silver, and a wedge of gold of 50 shekels weight, then I coveted them. See, I coveted them. See? And took them, and behold, they are hid in the earth in the midst of my tent, and the silver under it. Just like Jeroboam. Jeroboam coveted Rehoboam. See, the same thing happened again. Covetousness. And in the law, it says, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor. See that? So those which have the mark of the beast, right? They covet the things of Babylon. They want the lies. You see what I say? Because here it says, he, when I saw the, among the spoils a goodly Babylonish garment and 200 shekels of silver. See that? So that cursed thing is the things of Babylon. The accursed thing, the mark of the beast, the spirit of sin, you know, hypocrisy. That's the mark of the beast. You see? Mark chapter 7, verse 7. Mark chapter 7, verse 7. Howbeit in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrine the commandments of men. See that? Howbeit in vain do they worship him, teaching for doctrine the commandments of men. Right, so when you teach the commandments of men, you worship God in vain. And that's what the beast do. The beast teach the doctrines of men. Right? That's what the beast do. So that's the mark of the beast. That's a sign of the mark of the beast, when you're teaching the doctrines of men and not the doctrine of God. Alright. Let's go on now. Let's go to which other one? Go to another thing again. Deuteronomy 32 verse 5, it says, they have corrupted themselves. See, the beast has corrupted himself. The beast which has sent out of the sea, the beast that John saw rising up out of the sea, they have corrupted themselves. And these are those which have not believed in Christ. And this is speaking of many people. Right? The beast is a nation. Represents a nation. Right? Okay? Because even children of Israel was knit together as one man. See, the whole congregation of Israel was knit together as one man. And you have to remember that the darkness and the light are both alike. And whosoever is joined to an harlot is one body. See? You have to remember all those scriptures. Watching, it says, they have corrupted themselves, their spot is not the spot of his children. See, so they have a mark, but not the mark of his children. We have a mark of his children. You understand? Which is the Holy Spirit, the seal of God. We have His mark in our forehead, see? His law is written in our forehead. That's what we have in our forehead, right? It says, your spot is not the spot of His children. They are a perverse and crooked generation. Yes, a perverse and crooked generation. You see that? Do you thus requite the Lord, O foolish people and unwise, see? And that's why David said, I was as a beast. How foolish was I and ignorant. I was as a beast before thee. See that? It says, is not he thy father that hath bought thee? Hath he not made thee and established thee? Remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations. Ask thy father and he will show thee. See? Ask thy father and he will show thee. Who is thy father? Christ. And he will show thee. See? He will show thee. The book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. Ask and it shall be given you. Seek and it shall find. Knock and it shall be opened to you. Right? So if you ask, it shall be given to you. See? Open the book and study and it will be given to you. Just ask. See? Verse 11. If ye then being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children. Yeah. If you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. Right? How much more shall your Father which is in heaven give good things to them that ask him? See that? If you being evil know to give your children good gifts, and the Lord is greater than you, how much more good will he give unto you? Or give unto them that ask him, how much more? How much more? If ye being evil and know to give your children good gifts, how much more better of a gift shall the Lord give unto those that ask him? You see? But this is what they have done. Share something. So, we got the Psalms. The book of Psalm, chapter 10, verse 4. The wicked, through the pride of his countenance, will not seek after God. God is not in all his thoughts. Yes, so that's the mark of the beast, right? They will not seek after God. God is not in all their thoughts. Why? Because Satan is in all their thoughts. See? The heart of man imagine evil continually. Go to here. Go to Genesis. Genesis chapter 6, verse 5. And God saw the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. See, that's the Lord saw that. The heart of man was evil continually. See, he had the mark of the beast. So the mark of the beast is not something recent. The mark of the beast has been from ages. See that? It has been from ages. Watch it now. Let's go to verse 12. Verse 12 and 13. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt. See, that core of Babylon is corrupt. The earth is corrupt. They which have received the mark of the beast, they are corrupt. See? Earth also was corrupt before God, and earth was filled with violence. That's what we read. That's what we read about in Ezekiel chapter 28. See? How because of his beauty, of his merchandise, he was filled with violence. See? And the earth was filled with violence. And the earth represents our people. See that? It says, and God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh are corrupted his way upon the earth. Here verse 13. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I'll destroy them with the earth. See, so you shall destroy them with the earth. So the end is now come, because why? And this is the final scripture. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. Start from verse 1. But there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privately shall bring in damnable heresies. See, fox coming in, right? Wolves in sheep clothing coming in to slaughter the flock. So it says, who privately shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord, see? Saying that Christ is not God, and Christ is not the Son of God, and you know, Christ didn't come here for no purpose, and you know, all sorts of bad things. All sorts of, you know, untruths, right? So it says, denying the Lord that bought them. See, that talking about Noah do exist and all those people do exist. That those things are just allegories and those people never exist. That is heresies. Virgin, if you check yourself, Virgin. You see, Watch this, says, but there are false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. And many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. See, that way of truth is evil being spoken of. So that's why the Lord said, then this come, because the earth is filled with violence and corrupt, can speak evil of the way of truth.